The movie business, the glitz, the glamour, the high life.
The hairdryers, the hats, the highs, the lows.
Where movie stars live in the lap of luxury, and we lived in a little caravan with a tiny toilet.
I bet Robert De Niro doesn't have to pick up the stool just so you can have a wee underneath in the bog.
This is our first movie.
And action.
Hello and welcome to the making of our first ever feature film, Alien Autopsy. Over the next 45 minutes, we'll be showing you how the whole thing was put together.
And to do that, we've come back to Elan Studios, where most of the film was made. And you really couldn't ask for a more glamorous location.
Yeah. Anyway, coming up, we've got a look at some of the brilliant special effects. We've got exclusive footage of us filming in Hollywood, an Access All Areas look at the premiere, plus lots more stuff you won't see anywhere else.
And you get to see us two acting. You'll see all the laughter.
The laughter.
You'll see the tears.
Oh, the tears. There's a lot of tears. Oh, there's a lot of tears.
What are you doing?
Just acting for everybody.
Well, don't. Okay?
Okay.
Now, the first thing you need when you're making a film is a story. A story that the audience will find exciting.
Exciting! That's exciting, isn't it? Like, this type of story. It all started when a screenwriter was summoned to meet two strangers who said they had a story that was quite literally out of this world.
I get to the office, really in a bad mood, didn't want to be there, to meet these two blokes, and they weren't there.
What do you mean they're not here?
And I was so hacked off. And what was there was Michael with this whacking great confidentiality agreement.
Oh. They won't come up unless I phone them and tell them that you've signed this.
So I signed this wretched thing and waited, and then 5 minutes later up the stairs come these two incredibly eccentric blokes.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Ray Santilli. This is my friend, Gary Shuffield.
Hi.
You've probably never heard of us, though, have you?
Correct.
And he said, well, go over to Michael's laptop, type my name into Google and see what happens.
S-A-N-T-I...
Double L. Hi.
Yeah. How many hits?
3,982,400 and...
7.
Ray looked at me and he was grinning at this stage and he just said, you know, I bet you want to hear our story now.
In 1995, my good friend Ray over here acquired footage of an alien autopsy.
The story that we were sitting on was the most valuable story in ufology.
When the film was first broadcast in 1995, it was watched by millions of people in over 32 countries. Ever since then, people have been arguing over whether the footage is genuine or fake.
But finally, Ray and Gary decided it was time to tell their story.
So that's our plot. It's all about Ray, Gary, and the alien autopsy footage they sold to the world.
Brilliant. We've got a great story. What do we do next?
Next, you need a director.
Someone creative.
Ready?
Most importantly, someone who's good at shouting action.
Action!
Oh, he's good.
Will Davis rings up and told me about the project. He's got this amazing story that he's written a script about, and he can't tell me that much about it over the phone. So immediately you think, oh, sounds a bit more interesting than normal, you know. And he said, in fact, I'd actually have to get you to sign a confidentiality agreement before telling you any more. It's basically about a couple of characters called Ray and Gary, friends who inadvertently stumble across this historic piece of footage over in America, which was sold to them by an old former military cameraman.
Can you say that again?
The film showed the autopsy of an alien being.
They brought this footage back to the UK, and our film follows the events thereafter.
Does
So there's a story and a director. Now it's time to find two guys willing to play Ray and Gary.
Yes, two best friends who might want to star in a Hollywood film. Where would you find two guys like that, I wonder?
I wonder.
And you're telling me, out of all the people on the planet, you're the one who's been blessed with this discovery.
Isn't it brilliant?
Initially, we were... The main casting was Ray and Gary, these two friends who have to play early 20s and kind of early 30s. And, you know, we wanted... There was a lot of comedy in the script, and so we wanted to, you know, maybe get a couple of comedy stars together. But you end up thinking, well, is the chemistry really going to work between them?
Do you have any idea how exhausting it is always being right and never being listened to?
You know, when you get angry like this, you've got a little vein pops up.
Shut up!
In the middle of last year's I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, my girlfriend one evening said to me, you know, when I loved I'm a Celebrity, she said to me, have you ever thought about Anton Deck for Ray and Gary? And I thought, oh, don't be ridiculous, you know. And then after he said it, I kind of looked and thought, you know, actually, it's not a bad idea.
I think that we were nervous when the idea of Anton Deck first came up. I think that you have such a strong idea in your head of them as presenters that, you know, the two questions come up. First of all, can they act? And secondly, can they lose their television persona?
When the idea had come up originally of them playing us, I had my doubts.
How are you ever going to date a Page 3 girl or drive a Pontiac GTO working as a lawyer for a biscuit firm?
Ray said to me, wait until you see the screen test. If they're not really very good, then fair dues, but if they are, then, you know, maybe make a judgment on that basis. And when we saw the screen test, they were fantastic.
Aren't you tired of playing it safe yet?
Cheers, mate.
I mean, take a risk. Bet on yourself.
Bet on yourself?
There!
I was especially pleased when I heard it was Deck playing me. Just thought he was the better looking of the two of them.
I just hope people can see past my good looks and enjoy the film.
Oh, shut up.
So, the story's in place. Coming up, we meet the rest of the cast and we head off to Hollywood. Not that Tinseltown affected us in any way, you understand. We're just as down to earth as we've always been, isn't that right, Al?
We certainly are. It'll take more than 2 weeks in LA to change us two. Fancy some lunch?
I do, yeah. Bernard! Bernard, where have you been? Take me to catering quickly, and if the foie gras is not right, I'm holding you responsible.
Come on, Chop Chop! Have you done my laundry, Bernard? For your sake, I hope so. Good.
Hello? Hello? Could you get me my agent?
Want a biscuit?
No, I don't want a biscuit.
They're lovely, these are.
We've got work to do.
Have one, can't you?
Biscuit mad you are.
Welcome back to the making of our very first film, Alien Autopsy.
So we've got a brilliant story, we've got a brilliant director, and we've got two brilliant... Well, we've got two lead actors.
Yeah. So the next job was finding the rest of the cast, and as well as some brilliant British actors, we got to work with two of Hollywood's finest, Harry Dean Stanton and Bill Pullman.
Now, they've been in films like Independence Day, The Green Mile, and Alien. And when we sat down and talked to them about I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, and Saturday Night Takeaway, they pretended, right, that they'd never even heard of us.
Yeah.
What a pair of jokers!
Jokers.
We had a long debate about who should play Morgan Banner, the documentary filmmaker. And Will suggested try and Bill Pullman.
I make documentaries. They put them in cinemas all over the world. For millions of people to watch them.
I play Morgan Banner, who is a documentary filmmaker, who gets invited by an English producer who has a story that he thinks I'd be interested in getting involved with, and it draws me into this very strange world.
This had better be so good.
Harvey, the cameraman who shot the original Autopsy film back in 1947, off the page, it was just so clearly Harry Dean Stanton to me.
Jesus! He scared the life out of me.
They called me, said that I was the only one that should do the part, which is always good to hear.
You see, I have another piece of film I think
you'll be interested in.
What is it?
I don't have it with me. But you've really got to see it to understand.
Anthony and Deck, I didn't know anything about them. I didn't know them. But Johnny Campbell told me all about them, and they're obviously a popular duo in London, right?
There he goes again, pretending he doesn't have a clue who we are.
Oh, what a joker.
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 I can't. Harvey wants $30,000 for the film. Where am I going to get $30,000 from?
I don't know, and I don't care.
I need an investor, Gary, to put up the money. You have to help me.
Ray needs an investor, someone who will give him $30,000 for the film.
So he goes to see a very shady character named Laszlo Vorosh.
Who could quite possibly be the tallest man in the world.
Hmm.
Mr. Vorosh. Good evening.
If you ever speak to me again without being spoken to first, I will happily sit here flossing my teeth while Zachary is breaking every single bone in your body.
I'm playing Laszlo Vorosh. He is an Hungarian art and coke dealer in London in the 90s.
Are you lying to me about what's on this film?
No. No, no. I swear to you, everything I've told you is absolutely true.
He is mad about anything that has to do with extraterrestrial life, UFOs, crop field circles, all that stuff.
Vorosh agrees to the $30,000, so Ray brings the film back to England and holds a special screening in his front room.
Just come on, take a minute.
I told you this would be a laugh.
No, that's not what I saw. That's not.
But something terrible has happened. The film has been wiped clean, which leaves Ray and Gary with a bit of a dilemma.
They couldn't tell Vorosh the film was ruined because he's a proper gangster and, well, he wouldn't take it too well.
No. So Ray comes up with a plan to just remake the footage that the cameraman originally showed him. To do that, Ray and Gary need help from their friends and family.
Starting with Morris, Ray's nan's boyfriend.
Oh, hello.
How do you support yourself? Hmm?
I run my own business.
Really? Doing what exactly?
I make those.
It gives Ray this idea. He thinks he makes mannequins.
Morris can make us an alien. Then I can film it.
Film it?
I know what I saw, Gary. All we gotta do is copy it.
You can't even take a photograph of your nan sitting on the sofa without cropping her head off. How are you going to shoot an entire alien autopsy?
Not me. Melik.
Melik runs a kebab shop.
I play Melik, who is a kebab shop owner who does wedding videos in his spare time.
There's Preston, the local butcher.
He's responsible for the blood and guts.
We've got some mints and some pig's blood balled up in some lady's tights inside. It'll look just like the exposed brain.
And Edgar, who's the local undertaker.
And I work alongside Morris, getting the alien looking right, basically using his expertise in mortician makeup.
Such brilliant actors, so professional, so versatile, really brought the whole story to life.
Yeah, we were quite good, weren't we?
No, I was talking about the rest of the cast.
Oh, them! Yeah. Yeah, I suppose they're okay too, yeah.
It's so important to have a strong cast, isn't it?
Mm.
And what's more important is chemistry. And when you've been working together for as long as we have, that kind of thing comes naturally. I mean, we can even finish each other's
sentences. After a while, it just becomes second nature, and that kind of thing can really help.
On a film set? It's just so easy. There's total trust. I mean, for instance, we'd never mention
Ant's hairy back.
Oh, cheers. Thank you. I thought we'd never mention
your hairy back.
No, my secrets.
Oh, your secrets. Not your hairy back.
No. Anyway, so we've got the story, we've got the cast. All we need now is an alien.
Just get a bit of wax on it. Go whack. I'll come off.
The alien that features in our film is a version of familiar alien likenesses that people are used to.
Ta-da!
Oh,
Now, we remoulded an old maternity mannequin we used to make for mother care. Mm-hmm. Added an extra finger to each hand, like you said, and extra toes to the feet.
The alien was originally made out of clay, and then we took moulds, and then we cast the alien into silicone rubber. As you can see, this is all quite flexible.
You lift that wrist up, and there is a kind of a, you know, a dead feel to it.
The leg bone is from a sheep's leg bone that I boiled up.
There's some brilliant methods of making innards that I'd never thought of before.
This mold-making material melts down, and if you heat it up and just pour it into cold water, you can get all these gizzard-type shapes.
I thought, that's what I think it would look like. Something very beautiful about the face, I think.
Yeah, it's pretty scary. I came in the other day and the lights weren't on, and it does look really disturbing.
So with everything ready, it was time to make the film. Now, before you even step onto the set, there are loads of things you have to do. You have to make sure you have the right clothes, you have to know your lines, you need loads of extras.
Yeah, look, like this guy. Must be part of that big Western they're filming here.
Yeah, yeah.
I love
yeah.
film studios. They're just so exciting. Mm. Anyway, back to Alien Autopsy. And my favourite thing about making... Sorry. Can we help you, pal?
Just leave him. He's probably part of the Western they're filming. Just carry on.
I'm not going to carry on until he's gone. Sorry, pal. We're filming here, all right.
Just leave it. Carry on.
Okay, who ordered the stripogram?
Carry on, Ant.
Booked in the name of Donnelly.
Here's the making of the film.
What have I told you about going to see Brokeback Mountain on your own?
When you finally get the film in LA, it's important to be very professional.
Hey, look! There's the sign! The big Hollywood sign!
Oh, it is! Are there a film crew? In the back of our car?
Brilliant! I still can't believe we got to go to America.
I know!
Us too, America!
What time is it now? It's about 10 o'clock in the morning. And I'm absolutely sweating.
Oh, it's boiling.
Why don't you come on inside and see lifestyles of the rich and famous? Come on in.
I'm coming to my crib. Here's my crib. That's it.
And this is my...
This is my luxury trailer. It's like we've been locked up for fighting in America or something. How showbiz is this?
This is the movies, people. This is the movies. I feel like I'm in prison, but I'm in the movies.
I bet Robert De Niro doesn't happen to pick up the stool just so he can have a wee underneath in the bog.
Now I'm off to do some more filming in my movie.
Okay.
I think Ant and Dec have a lot of fun playing Ray and Gary. I think people will go into the cinema thinking of them as Ant and Dec, the presenters, but will forget that very quickly and just enjoy them as actors.
What about him?
Cool skin mark, huh?
Bad lad. Bad Ray.
Excuse me. How would you like to make $500 and have a night in a clean hotel room?
What do I have to do?
Portland's man has showered and now gets his beard trimmed.
Oh, this is going to be such a cool movie.
Looking forward to that.
And do you remember Nicole, the lovely blonde American lady we got to work with?
Mm.
She said you were a terrible flirt.
Well, you know what I'm like with the ladies, Aunt?
No, she said you were a terrible flirt. Terrible at flirting.
Oh, I see.
I'm Amber Fuentes from Channel 5 News.
She was interesting and funny and talented and gorgeous.
Oh, Harvey, I'll see if he's available. All right.
Well, maybe we could wait inside.
Action!
Come on!
Harry Dean Stanton has this thing where, on the one hand, he's quite warm and cozy, but on the other, if you put him in a certain light, he's sort of very scary.
Jesus! He scared the life out of me. So this is Harvey's shed, where Ray buys the footage, or sees it for the first time. Come on in that look. Who would live in a shed like this?
Harry Dean Stanton.
Harry Dean Stanton. We've got old photos of Harry there. When he was a younger fella. And it's now 11:30 on Friday night.
And Harry wants to get finished because he wants to make last orders.
So make it good, Deck, will you? Make it good. Have your little lines.
Action!
Acting with Harry Dean Stanton, now that is pressure.
Yeah, just 1 hour till the bar shuts. Look, look, there's you opening the door. Ah, you're good, such a fine actor.
Thank you. And here's me now holding a torch.
Oh, yeah.
I do that so well, don't you think?
Yes.
I think that Oscar is in the bag. It's so mine. But the glamour of Hollywood couldn't last forever.
To the back next to the toilet.
Before long, it was back to London and here, Elan Studios, to film Ray and Gary's fake alien autopsy.
I'm a genius.
Now, the autopsy scene is the big one. The whole movie hangs on this moment, and it took absolutely ages to film.
I still can't believe someone left a banana skin on the floor.
And action.
Just get it, please.
Are we ready yet?
No. Is that
actual blood?
Well, it's pig's blood mixed with food dye.
Yeah. Got the rest of the guts in the corner over there by the sofa. Here, I've got some flat rib. Very nice. A bonus loin. 3 pounds of braised and mince.
Very well.
Oh, and 15 packets of sliced ham.
Oh, what's the ham for?
Sandwiches.
This is, you know, Full Metal Jacket, Ben Hur. You know, this is big Hollywood stuff in his head. You know, he's totally serious. Job's worth. He's been given a job to do.
Hey, look! Oh, you want me to mop that up, yeah?
Yeah? No, don't touch it!
That's well proper. It looks authentic. Yeah, anyway, you the director? No, me.
Isn't it amazing how when you film a rubber alien filled with fake guts and sheep bones through an old black and white camera, it actually starts to look really quite convincing.
Absolutely. You start to understand why people might have been fooled by the original all those years ago.
I remember having arguments with my mates about this film. They didn't believe it, and I said, it's got to be true, because look, there's a guy behind that glass, and I bet he's from the government. Only to discover that now I'm playing the guy behind the glass in this scene.
What's he doing? What do you think he's doing?
It's very spooky. 16mm black and white wobbly camera, and it just looks so authentic.
Sausage on a stick.
Cut!
So you just wrapped your first film. How does it feel?
Oh, it's amazing.
A relief?
Yes.
You feel a good, great sense of relief, do you?
I'm feeling more relief by the second.
And wiggle.
And that's a wrap.
So, after weeks of filming, the whole thing was finished, and I did manage to take a little souvenir
did
from the
you
set.
Know?
Yeah.
What did you take?
This. Lights, camera, action.
What do you think?
Hang on a minute. Of all the hundreds of props we used on the film Alien Autopsy, you took the director's megaphone.
Yep.
It's good. Really good. Still to come, the premieres in London, Dublin and Newcastle.
Fancy cup of tea? I've got some lovely biscuits.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah? Brilliant.
So we've seen how the film got made, now it's time for the premieres.
And we got to have three of them, one in London, one in Newcastle and one in Dublin.
Oh, and they were really, really good fun. People were wetting themselves with excitement.
You said you wouldn't mention that, I couldn't help it. It was exciting, wasn't it?
So we're ready, we're off to our very first movie premiere, very excited. Finish up the old champers.
Down in one.
No, come on. Very nervous, wondering if people are going to be there, how many people are going to turn up. No one might turn up. So, you know, fingers crossed. You ready? Should we go? Or should I wait for you to finish that? No?
I'll finish that.
OK, here we go. Fingers crossed.
When it came to the premieres, people turned up in their droves, and all because of one thing,
free tickets.
I kind of turned up thinking, ooh, we're going to go up the red carpet, that's exciting. It's kind of snot green,
Yes. Which was a bit of a surprise.
Here we go. I think we've done everything now. The film's just about to start. I hope I'm in time for the trailers. I love the trailers.
Yeah, I do. Let's get some popcorn. Come on.
The great thing about the premiere is there's always a party afterwards.
Well, everybody's watched it now. We're at the after-show party.
I was very, very nervous, I have to admit.
Yeah, extremely nervous. And you're kind of sitting there, you're waiting for everybody to laugh or do something or have any kind of reaction. And we're sitting there and the first time they laugh went, oh, that's good, there's a laugh, there's a laugh.
I really enjoyed it and I had no idea what to expect. Genuinely, honestly, really enjoyed it.
It was funny. It was very funny.
It's a terrific story and very well done. Some really very funny moments in there.
I think all that's left for us to do now is have a few drinks.
We're just about to get on a private jet, which is very showbiz. I wish it was a little bit better to appreciate it, to be honest.
Just hope we've got sick bags. Wicked!
Brilliant. I'm gonna get used to this, I tell you.
How are you enjoying your private jet?
It's very nice, it's very luxurious. It's all leathery.
Get this out, free pork pie and scotch eggs. Free! Wow! What are you eating?
Just happy. Happy. Hello, Newcastle! I thought it was going to be a bit like the Beatles coming home, and look! There's nobody here! Watching it again for the second time tonight. We watched it last night. At 17.
But the more times you watch it, the more times you spot little things that you could have done better, or why was I doing that? So
I don't. I couldn't have done anything any better.
Now, we promised last time we wouldn't get drunk and we're not hungover today, are we?
No!
No!
Oh! I feel awful.
Thank you.
Hello. Look at you checking me out. This is the most casual of premieres, so I thought the most casual of suits.
Right.
It's blue by our tailor, Tom Baker. It has the little I Hate School badge in the inside there. I'm just a light blue shirt.
You looking forward to it tonight?
I am looking forward to tonight, because it's the last one. I think we'll have a bit of a party tonight. I think it's going to be a bit of a laugh.
For a change.
And I'm looking forward to seeing the film again. Kisses in Newcastle. A bit more of that in Dublin, please.
Well done.
Yeah.
There you go.
What are you doing here?
What are you doing here? We went in, we introduced the film, everyone's quite happy, they're sat there, but the Arsenal Juventus game's on, so we slipped out the back. We've seen it one or two times.
It's kind of the third night in a row. I mean, you know, I don't really want to watch myself three nights in a row.
That would just be big headed, I think it's good that we're coming down. Keeping our feet on the ground.
Yeah, keeping our feet on the ground.
Yeah.
We're not being vain by watching ourselves again. Does that wash?
Is that a good excuse? But anyway, that's it now. That's the third screen in Dublin. We're going to have a bit of a party tonight, but that was the end of our week. Hope you've enjoyed watching us, and we hope you enjoy the film.
So that's how we made Alien Autopsy. We really enjoyed making the film. Hope you enjoyed seeing behind the scenes. And we learned so much, didn't we? From acting in Hollywood to special effects to world premieres.
But most importantly, this film has proved once and for all that aliens really do exist. Good night, and thanks for watching.
And cut.
Wicked, see you all in the bar.
What'd you say that for?
What?
Aliens really do exist. We didn't prove that.
We did, really. Have you not been watching for the last 3/4 of an hour what we've been doing?
Oh, it's just aliens. That's a film, isn't it?
It's about aliens.
Yes, I know it's about aliens, but that wasn't a real alien that you cut open. That was a dummy, wasn't it? It wasn't a real alien.